Hi, I'm Dimitri Gagliardi from the Manchester Institute of Innovation Research at the University of Manchester. In this clip, we'll talk about the FinTech ecosystem. We'll look at characteristics, innovation types, and recent trends. The content of this clip consists in look at the FinTech revolution, how we got where we are, look at the FinTech ecosystem and its components, then innovation in the FinTech ecosystem and recent trends. So the FinTech revolution. Well, modern banking and financial system have been characterized by a string of structural changes underpinned by the introduction of and application of subsequent waves of information and communication technologies. ICTs have been used to increase processing capacity, introduce new, more efficient products and services, as well as attract to the banking and financial system larger and larger share of customers. These generate a long-term dynamic of increasingly specialized activities, both within banking and financial institutions, so we've been through organizational change, as well as in the customer-facing activities and this broad specialization in products and services. From a technological perspective, there are five domains that have been leveraged by FinTech and traditional banking and financial institutions alike to foster this digitization process. These technological domains are security and privacy to protect system, transaction, identify correctly the users, etc. Data-oriented application, whereby we assist to data mining processes, data analytics, as well as processing facilities and equipment. In fact, we see an increase in distributed services and networking between the various elements of the system. And then a fourth place, we have applications. We talk about mobile applications, we're talking about risk management application, as well as digital platform technologies with their APIs, etc. And of course, service models, because we talk about organizational services, we're talking about the introduction of cloud computing and user mobile interfaces. Now, if we go from the beginning, we see that the introduction of the telegraph, which increased the speeding of communication, introduced already many innovations in the system. And if we progress through the years to nowadays, we see how magnetic strips, microchips, and computer hardware have been adopted by the banking and financial sectors through credit card payment, debit cards, etc., etc. With the advent of the internet in the 80s and 90s, we see a reduction in branches and with further development of financial and banking products and services. But it's only recently that the FinTech revolution has consolidated, has brought to the market online banking, mobile banking, etc. So technologies like DLT and blockchain, payment technology from QR code, near-field communication, etc., digital platform, have been fostered a process of digitization, bringing us robo-advisors, automated trading, contactless payment, as well as crowdfunding, peer-to-peer lending, microcredit, and other alternative forms of finance. In the FinTech ecosystem, we see five main actors, the FinTech firms, that are those who produce and apply these technologies. We talk about technology developers, who are those who design and develop the coding and the technology used in this sort of transaction, as well as the traditional financial institutions such as banks and financial services firms that apply these technologies into their processes, as well as government, who is in charge of regulating the whole system. Let's not forget the financial customers. In fact, we have users that are using these services as savers and investors and their current account through payment, etc. But we also have firms that use banking and financial services in their day-to-day transaction. Innovation in the fintech ecosystem. Well, innovation in the ecosystem is as diverse as its stakeholders. To start with, let's look at how in the past we've seen many disruptive waves of innovation. Well, now these are more or less quite down, and we see a lot of incremental innovation that are providing refined financial products and services to meet the diverse needs of organizations, that is bank financial organization moving towards the fintech, and also of customers that such as users, investors and borrowers who access these services much easier, sometimes seamlessly. The object of innovation within the sector concerns the business model. Of course, all the business models are not anymore suited for carried out this sort of activities that are increasingly based on digital technology. And of course, changing the business model would also mean, to this extent, of course, would also mean changing, introducing organizational innovation. With that comes products and services innovation. New processes are introduced, as well as the system of conducting business within the sector is being changed. The scope of innovation, well, clearly there is a change within the banking and financial services for and because of the introduction of fintech, as well as customers face innovation whereby the introduction of these technologies and means of conducting business is changing the way people operate. Few words on recent trends. Well, recent trends of fintech show that there is a continuous and sustained growth in almost all segments of the sector. By now, 2019, North America is no longer leading in terms of investment and growth. Asian countries have grown by 165% in 2008 versus North America that grew only 43% and Europe a meager 25%. South American investments in this area, though starting from a lower position, have increased also by 167%, producing some of the world unicorns in fintech. So, with many fintech companies moving towards consolidation, consolidating their position in their respective field, they are also expanding in complementary product and service areas. This means that within this trend, the most successful fintech companies are moving into banking by seeking and obtaining banking license with their own regulators or from regulators in other countries. The current playing field of new banking and other financial operation is to gain customers' deposits. That means blending traditional banking operation within their fintech operation to increase their saving and investment account. So whilst payment tech segments continue to be the largest fintech segment, RegTech, regulatory technology, is the segment that has seen the sharpest increase in investment in 2018. And then we see that regulatory aspects involve the open banking initiative, open API, and payment service directive too. These are setting off in Europe and will certainly define the course of the sector in the next few years.